Hello everyone, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 261. Taiwanese laptop and PC maker Acer today announced the loot out store sale that brings discount on many of its products in India. The company said that the discount will be applicable between December 16th and 17th and will be applicable only in products sold through Acer's online store. The others include discounts of up to 67% on the company's gaming devices and accessories, while peripherals and some other products are also included in this sale. Acer's air purifier will also be available for sale on the Laos here and sale. With the collaboration of the Asus and Intel, the Incredible Unfold CES 2022 launch event will be conducting on January 5, 2022 around 9:30 PM IST. At the same time, Asus is going to launch a gaming laptop and the launch event is scheduled for January 6 around 12 AM IST. This year is going to end soon, and this means that annual Customer Electronics Show is just around the corner. As usual, it will take place in the first week of January, and Samsung, as one of the participants, has just scheduled its pre-show keynote. Together for tomorrow's show, it will take place on January 4, 2022, where we can expect to see the new Galaxy S21 Fan Edition smartphone. LG Electronics today unveiled a lively video featuring John Legend, the award-winning artist and a new LG signature brand ambassador, to kick off LG participation in CES 2022, set to the theme The Better Life You Deserve. The approximately 30-second teaser video invites guests to LG World Premiere on January 4th at 8 AM PST. That was the LG's official announcement event at CES. Food delivery unicorn Swiggy and integrated airspace company Adra Technologies have jointly conducted over 300 drone-led deliveries of food and medicines in India. The trials were part of the project awarded to the companies by the Directorate General of Civil Aviation and Ministry of Civil Aviation, and will help prepare for the next set of drone rules for beyond visual line of sight operations. The company claimed that this was the first time such missions have been carried out in India. Tecno partnered with Samsung to bring the RGBW sensor to its upcoming phones. That, as it turns out, is only one of the three camera innovations coming to future models from the company. It will also adopt sensor shift image stabilization as well as develop a telescopic zoom lens. That's not all, Tecno is planning to use a combination of glass and plastic lens to increase the camera's light gathering ability by another 30%. The RGBW sensors need a different image processing algorithm, of course, and the company plans to develop one in-house. The first Tecno phone with the upgraded RGBW camera will be arriving in 2022. Tecno Spark 80 comes as a successor to the Spark 70. The key specifications include a 6.6-inch display, MediaTek Helio G35 processor, Android 11 OS, and a 5000mAh battery. Tecno Spark 80 will go on sale through the Amazon India. Oppo Find N foldable phone can withstand over 200,000 folds. This device comes with a starting price of 7,699 Chinese yuan, that is approximately ₹92,290. It will be available only in China for now. Minecraft was launched in 2011, and in 10 years the game has managed to become among the most played and the best selling titles, with around 140 million active players across the world. Today the game has achieved another milestone, probably the biggest milestone any game has ever achieved. Minecraft content has surpassed over 1 trillion total views of Minecraft content. This makes it the most viewed game content on this platform. Ola Electric starts deliveries of the Ola S1 and Ola S1 Pro from today. The Ola S1 and S1 Pro production versions will come out of the market 4 months after the models were first announced. Ola S1 and S1 Pro deliveries got delayed due to chip and electronic shortages, as well as an issues with getting the clearances from all the states. Realme has officially announced that the upcoming Realme GT2 series will feature a piece of paper science and technology. This announcement post also revealed an event for the device scheduled for the December 20th. Jio has introduced the cheapest prepaid plan at 1 rupee. The 1 rupee prepaid plan from Jio offers 30 days validity and 100 MB of data. Jio noted that its users will be able to make recharges through WhatsApp soon. Amazon India announced that over 10 lakh sellers are now selling on Amazon.in from across India. It claimed that more than 90% of the sellers on Amazon.in are small and medium local businesses, and over half of these sellers are on the marketplace come from Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. And the company says that since January 2020, more than 4.5 lakh new sellers have been joined Amazon.in. Android 12 Go edition for the low-end devices have been unveiled. The OS is claimed to launch application up to 30% fast compared to previous Go edition Android versions, and the animation are claimed to be smoother too. Android 12 Go edition will be available on low-end phones in 2022. WhatsApp's voice messages are really popular, as unlike on Facebook Messenger, you are not time limited. And you can also see when they have been listened to. You can even change the speed at which to hear them. And from now on, you get another neat feature, the ability to listen to the voice messages before you send it. In order to do this, you need to press and hold the mic icon as usual in order to record a voice message. Then slide up to go into hands-free recording mode. When you are done, then tap to the stop button in the center and press play to preview your message. If you are satisfied with it, hit the send button and off it goes. The Union Cabinet on Wednesday approved a 76,000 crore rupees incentive plan to woo semiconductor fabricators and display manufacturers, doubling down on the center push to make India a global electronic production hub. Under this scheme, the country will be able to set up over 20 semiconductor design, component manufacturing and display fabrication units over the next 6 years. An ambitious project to establish a complete ecosystem of the semiconductors and display manufacturing has been sanctioned. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.